The deeds of mercy have always been highly esteemed merits in the social sphere of Bosnia and Herzegovina. Unfortunately, the last war in the country superseded the basics of humanity. It was the time when people of BNH started a fundamental struggle for survival that in some cases exposed elements of inhumanity and dishonesty. Yet the humanism prevailed, even in the most difficult moments. It gave a ray of hope that there was no dark force that could deprive the most valuable human qualities. In such severe times, when the value of food was as high as the value of medicaments, two humanists, Rudić Salem and his spouse Hatija, established the humanitarian organization Ruhama. The main objective was to help socially most handicapped population, the old and disabled people. The main reason for making a decision to devote their life to a care for the old and sick people was the death of their old neighbor, who was a proud and dignified person hardly being able to ask for help. This sad event was the first signal to the Rudić's to open their hearts and start helping people in need. The humanitarian organization Ruhama was founded in the war year 1993 and was immediately registered by the High Court Senica as non-governmental, non-political, democratic, non-profitable organization. Therefore, it is necessary to mention that the organization has been functioning for 10 years now. During this period, its staff provided 1,750,000 visits and services to the clients, and thus saved thousands' lives. It was the time when hundreds of young volunteers aged between 12 and 22 opened the doors of their friendship and charity for the old and disabled people who were abandoned by their families. We all together helped them to overcome the crisis and to become aware that there were still people to take care of them. Each volunteer was responsible for 10 people, regardless the weather conditions, and sometimes even risking their own lives in the period of armed fights. These young people were delivering food to our patients from one part of town to another. They were also helping the clients with the houseworks that included a distribution of firewood, house cleaning, making dishes, and other services required in the moment. The health care was undertaken by our expert medical teams, which used to do medical checks, prescribe therapies, and apply the latter in the houses of patients. The nursing teams were maintaining hygiene of patients and of environment where they lived. Very close ties and confidence that arose between our young volunteers and the old beneficiaries of their services has always been a key point of a successful work of Ruhama, and that is what our most important project, the Home Care Project, is based on. The Home Care Project was made and has been implemented for years now with the only one objective, to help every person who has requested it or has been in need for help, regardless his national, cultural or social background. The main power of the project has been the mobile team consisted of 240 volunteers. This team started its activities without any financial support, but has never stopped providing the patients with necessary aid. People of different ages and educational background, high school students, doctors, medical technicians, social workers, psychologists, and others who have not spared their time and efforts to help other people joined this team. The carriers of the Home Care Project, with its health, hygienic, humanitarian program, have carried out their activities in the main office of Ruhama, as well as the houses of the patients. These activities are divided into as two different programs. Medical program that includes medical care of patients, medical examinations, laboratory tests, ECG checks, changing catheters, bandaging of decubital wounds, giving injections, etc. As to the registry books of Ruhama, there have been 382,000 medical services provided in the last 10 years. The second program is maintenance of hygiene program that includes maintaining of personal hygiene of the patients, nursing, bathing, changing clothes, feeding, doing haircut and shaving, maintaining of hygiene of the rooms where patients live, doing laundry like washing and ironing. As to the registry books of Ruhama, there have been 397,200 services provided in the last 10 years. The third program is humanitarian program that includes a distribution of humanitarian aid, like 3,000 tons so far in average. The items mainly delivered are nutrition goods, hygienic kits, clothes, shoes, bed linens, blankets, firewood, stoves, disposable grills, sanitary sets, etc. As to the registry books of Ruhama, there have been 894,420 services provided in the last 10 years. Not only that Ruhama has helped the old people and children with special needs, but has helped different institutions in the town, non-governmental organizations, citizens' associations, etc. Finally, the fourth program is additional program that includes the transport of patients to hospital for dialysis, chemotherapy, or to the administration institutions like bank or post office if necessary. This program also includes the services provided by handymen, social worker and volunteers. In total, there are 9,800 old people provided with the services mentioned in the programs of Ruhama. In order to implement each of the listed programs properly, we established four mobile teams: medical team, nursing team, team of cleaning ladies, team of volunteers. Ruhama has provided these teams with necessary equipment like vacuum cleaners, irons, washing and drying machines, equipment pieces for barber services, newest equipment for laboratory services. The vehicles that the organization had or still has at disposal are one Land Rover, one Lada, one ambulance car, one Nissan Jeep, one Golf, one Opel Kadett, etc. However, we do not want to keep our job static, but we are going to struggle in order to expand our activities and to provide our teams with better working conditions so that they could improve the quality of services they give to the patients.
Polazeći toga da je Ruhama, dakle, u jednom desetogodišnjem periodu, nakon što je formirana, dakle, 93. godine u najtežim, dakle, u jednom u najtežem vremenskom periodu u Bosni i Hercegovini, da je ona u tom desetogodišnjem periodu uspjela stvoriti ime stvoriti ime, dakle Ruhama, i postati prepoznatljiva upravo po naslovu same humanitarne organizacije. Dakle, za Ruhamu se zna, to je ono što je bilo najteže, zapravo što je u životu i u poslu najteže učiniti. Ruhama je u tome uspjela i je postala prepoznatljiva kao humanitarna organizacija koja je dala i daje svoj doprinos na planu ukupnog socijalnog zbrinjavanja stanovništva. Zapravo ona daje dakle, dio svoga doprinosa u toj oblasti, budući da i prema federalnom zakonu iz ovih oblasti i humanitarne organizacije, dakle, mogu da obavljaju socijalnu zaštitu i učestvuju praktično u socijalnom zbrinjavanju građana i stanovništva.
SD awards for all its efforts in the field of humanitarian activities conducted with a big support of UNHCR, Ruhama was registered in 1995 in the list of the World Humanitarian Organizations. Besides, it got different letters of recognition for its work from the federal ministries, local, state and international institutions, two of which are the plaque of Zenica given by the municipal authorities, and the other one was given to the Rudis, who were declared the persons of the year in Zenica. Due to improve their skills and knowledge referring to the humanitarian work, Rudic Salim and Hatija, as well as the other members of Ruhama, participated in 120 seminars and educative programs that were held in several countries of Europe and United States. Many international organizations gave their financial support to Ruhama, as to the recommendation of UNHCR and the Caritas International. This is also the sign that Ruhama has always been considered as respectable and professional organization, not only in our country but in the world. Last year, Ruhama became a member of the Innovative Forum of the organizations working on the home care projects in the Central and East Europe. The work of the organization is open to public. All documents on our activities, receive donations, distribution of humanitarian aid, visits of doctors or volunteers to the patients, visits of the local or state authority members, and visits of the representatives of humanitarian organizations are kept in our registry books. Besides, Ruhama has its own video archives. Every year we send periodical and annual reports, as well as the reports of the International Revision Control made once a year to the main office of UNHCR in Geneva. Finally, certainly not the least important, in the last 10 years Ruhama has been supported by many international organizations like UNHCR, Equilibre, IRC, MPA, World Vision, MDM, WHO, UNICEF, MSF, PSF, AMCOR, Crossroads, Manson in Note, World Church Service, Caritas International, etc. The true friend of our organization have been people of Turkey, Germany, Dutch SFOR, Dutch Embassy, Canadian Embassy, our dear friends Andre and Mara, Stefan and Mary. Some time ago, few private companies from Zenica also took a part in humanitarian program. The final goal of Ruhama is still not defined. However, we are doing our best to achieve the main objective of the organization, and that is to help people in need. There are still some plans for the future work of Ruhama. The main idea is to build a geriatric center where the health hygienic services would be provided in one place and would be based on the principles of democracy, voluntarism and humanity.